My name is Mark Lozell, and I'm the Business Website Director at Healy Consultants Group PLC, and I'm based in our Singapore office. I have with me today our Asia Pacific CEO, Mr. Simon Guidecop, and he's here to talk to us today about a recent engagement he completed in the Philippines. Simon, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Mark. I'm very pleased to speak with you today.
Good. Simon, please just give us a brief summary about the engagement and the client and what they were looking to do with the...
I'm not going to disclose the name of the client because I don't think we have their consent to do so. However, what I can tell is that this client is a group originating from Latin America, Uruguay, if I remember correctly, providing payment services to international clientele. That client has recently engaged the consultant group to expand overseas, outside of Latin America, and in particular in Africa. So that was our Dubai office who was taking care of those engagements. And I believe satisfied by the work that we were doing there, they also engaged us to expand in Southeast Asia, and in particular Philippines, two other countries where they engaged us being Vietnam, but Thailand and Malaysia.
Okay,
so in the Philippines, basically, so the purpose of expanding for them is to develop their banking relationship, notably to have local entities that can get bank accounts with local commercial banks. And that's why they engage us to register their companies. Do you have any question at that stage?
The Philippines, to perhaps the uninitiated, the Philippines would seem that it might be quite a complex engagement in terms of setting up entities there and what have you. What was your experience, actually?
So that's indeed a good point. I mean, Philippines, in Southeast Asia, Philippines probably, so after Myanmar, the most complex market for entry by for an investor. So there's multiple reasons for that. One of them being that the Philippines has a minimum capital requirement of 200,000 USD for normal company setup. But if you're planning to have trade with local customers, retail trade, so for example, let's say you're selling shoes, then the minimum capital requirement is indeed 2.5 million.
Right.
In the case of our client, as it's a B2B business, I mean, the standard capital requirement of 200,000 applies. So that's the first reason why company formation in the Philippines is complex for a foreigner. The second reason, so which no longer applies today, but still worth mentioning, is that they had a relatively old corporation code, so regulation regulating the formation of a company. So Philippines had a very unusual laws where if you want, you don't really have the private limited company like you have in Singapore, in Hong Kong, 99% of the countries on the planet. You either can register a limited liability partnership or a sole proprietorship, which is usually done by locals, not of very much interest for foreigners, or you had to register a joint stock corporation, which required at the time, so it's not anymore the case since 2019, but before 2019 you needed five shareholders and five directors. All the directors having to hold, if I remember correctly, one share in the business, and the majority of the board having to be resident in Philippines. So fortunately, and that simplified a lot setup in the Philippines, there's basically that old corporation code was scrapped by the government and replaced by a new one, which basically provides for the registration of corporation with no minimum number of shareholders. So you can register nowadays a corporation in the Philippines with only a single shareholder, or with two shareholders, three shareholders, four shareholders if you want, and there's no more requirement for the board to have a residence. You can instead appoint foreigners who lives overseas of Philippines. The only local appointment that you need is, in addition to a company secretary, you need a treasurer. So it's a role that basically consists into reviewing the financial statements, the bank statement. It's more an accounting type of role.
The engagement took place in the context of the coronavirus pandemic. Did that create any specific challenges? And if so, were we able to sufficiently overcome the challenges?
So it did, because so one of the requirements for our client was to get a company fast, due probably to their negotiation with the two banks that they were looking to partner with in the Philippines. They wanted a company number as soon as possible. And so in the current, that's anyway, when you set up a company overseas, challenging because you need to certify documentation, sometimes translate it. It's not the case in the Philippines, but it can be elsewhere. You need to legalize them at the local embassy, in our case, Philippines. And so in order to assist our client, what we did is that we provided with a temporary shareholder director of Filipino citizenship, who basically set up the business on their behalf. And later on, it's not already done, but later on, we will transfer back the shares to our client when they're ready to take them. In that context, I mean, Philippine banks still require a face-to-face meeting with authorized bank signatories before appointing them as authorized signatories. So in order to overcome that challenge with the engagement, we also appointed our nominee as temporary bank signatory until our client is able to travel to the Philippines. That can have some implication for the operation of the bank account, because the bank signatory is the person who's going to have the tokens, the password details, and so on. But we still managed to negotiate with the bank some kind of temporary solution where our client is appointed as an online banking user without being appointed formally as bank signatory. So that's the solution that we provided to that challenge.
Okay, very good. Finally, just a couple of key takeaways from the engagement, Simon. What do you feel were the main points that to emerge from this as we go forward, take into future Philippines engagements?
Well, so I would say in the Philippines, it's particularly important to plan ahead because once again, especially when you're investing as a foreigner, the amount of investment that you need to make in order to enter the market will really depend on your exact business activities. So once again, as I said earlier, if you're doing any retail trade, the paid up capital, I mean, is basically multiplied by 10. And the same applies to, for example, if you're operating, there's plenty of consideration regarding to your activities, what type of permit you need, where you need to get it. Registration requirement will also depend on the municipality where you register, because in addition to registering at the federal level with the Security Exchange Commission, so the equivalent of a corporate registrar, you need also to register at the municipality level and get trading license. So it's really important to basically get expert advice before entering the Philippines.
Okay. Thank you for your time. That was interesting. Thank you, Simon.
Thank you very much, Mark.